be with you.
And with your spirit.
And as we celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us recall those times that we have failed to serve the Lord with our whole heart, our whole soul, and to love our neighbor as ourselves. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who have given us St. Francis of Rome, a singular model of both Mary and monastic life, grant us perseverance in your service, that in every circumstance of life we may see and follow you. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. Azariah stood up in the fire and prayed aloud. For your name's sake, O Lord, do not deliver us up forever, or make void your covenant. Do not take away your mercy from us for the sake of Abraham, your beloved, Isaac, your servant, and Israel, your holy one, to whom you promised to multiply your offspring like the stars of heaven or the sand on the shore of the sea. For we are reduced, O Lord, beyond any other nation, brought low everywhere in the world this day because of our sins. We have in our day no prince, prophet, or leader, no burnt offering, sacrifice, oblation, or incense, no place to offer first fruits to find favor with you. But with contrite heart and humble spirit, let us be received. As though we were burnt offerings of rams and bullocks, or thousands of fat lambs. So let our sacrifice be in your presence today, as we follow you unreservedly, through those who trust in you cannot be put to shame. And now we follow you with our whole heart. We fear you and we pray to you. Do not let us be put to shame, but deal with us in your kindness and great mercy. Deliver us by your wonders and bring glory to your name, O Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Remember your mercies, O Lord. Remember your mercies, O Lord. Your ways, O Lord, be known to me. Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are God, my Savior. Remember your mercies, O Lord. Remember that your compassion, O Lord, and your kindness are from old. In your kindness, remember me because of your goodness, O Lord. Remember your mercies, O Lord. Good and upright is the Lord. Thus he shows sinners the way. He guides the humble to justice. He teaches the humble his way. Remember your mercies, O Lord.
Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
approached Jesus and asked him, "Lord, if my brother sins against me, how often must I forgive him? As many as 7 times?" Jesus answered, "I say to you, not 7 times, but 77 times. That is why the kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who decided to settle accounts with his servants. When he began his accounting, a debtor who brought him before him, who owed him a huge amount, since he had no way of paying it back, his master ordered him to be sold, along with his wife, his children, and all his property, payment of the debt. At that, the servant fell down and did him homage and said, 'Be patient with me, and I will pay you back in full.' Moved with compassion, the master of the servant let him go and forgave him the loan. When the servant had left, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him a much smaller amount. He seized him and started to choke him, demanding, 'Pay back what you owe me.' There, falling to his knees, his fellow servant begged him, 'Be patient with me, and I will pay you back.' But he refused. Instead, he had him put in prison until he paid back the debt. Now, when his fellow servants saw what had happened, they were deeply disturbed and went to their master and reported the whole affair. His master summoned him and said to him, 'You wicked servant, I forgave your entire debt because you begged me to. Should you have not had pity on your fellow servant as I had pity on you?' Then in his anger, his master handed him over to the torturers until he should pay back the whole debt. So will my Heavenly Father do to you, unless each of you forgives your brothers from your heart." The Gospel of the Lord. Daniel's compassion for Arizona stood up and prayed to God, "Do not take away your mercy, but with contrite heart and humble spirit, let us be received." This is a true story. This happened when I was a kid. As many of you know, I grew up in 63rd Patsy, not very far from here, and 63rd Street. This is 63rd Street, Central Park. There was a large truck, and it wedged itself beneath an underpass, the viaduct, outside. And it couldn't be moved backwards or forwards. And this happened a couple of times growing up when we walked to school. And I'm sure you can connect. Traffic was backed up for miles. No one knew how to free the truck. You couldn't go front, you couldn't go backwards. It was really wedged in there. The driver really wasn't paying attention. So then a little boy who had been watching, "I think I know how to free it." A frustrated police officer snapped, "I suppose you got it all figured out." "I think so," said the little boy. "Just let some air out of the tires." The officials did, and the truck passed through. You know, later everybody joked about the incident. And the truck wasn't the only one who got some air taken out of their tires. How do I respond when someone lets some air out of my tires and humbles me before others? Jesus said, "Learn from me because I am gentle and humble of spirit. When we have a relationship with Jesus, I know some people, everyone's relationship is different, and some people just don't have that relationship or are working towards it. But when you really get that relationship with the Lord, you really listen to Him guiding you, He humbles you. Not because He wants to punish you. He humbles us because He wants us to learn, and that's what a disciple does. It follows the Lord, it follows the Master, it learns from the Master. So when we get humble, let's not get upset with ourselves and feel all down and out. The question that we should ask is, okay, Lord, what are you trying to teach me through humbling me and letting air out of my tires? And when we learn, we grow more in wisdom. We grow more in faith. We grow more in our discipleship. And so Lent is a time to kind of take a step back and say, okay, where have I been humbled? And where have I grown from being humbled? I think an important lesson that we learned from the scriptures today, the servant was humbled and was forgiven. But he forgot the lesson of humility. What did he do? He did the exact opposite as was done to him. So then he had learned the lesson of humility all over again. The reason we keep on getting the air taken out of our tires is we haven't learned the lesson yet, totally, of humility and following the Lord. So that's a great challenge as we receive the Eucharist and say, okay, Lord, help me to be humbled. Help me to be the loving disciple that you call us to be from the heart. Contrite and humble hearts, let us rise and present our prayers, not only for ourselves, but for brothers and sisters in the world, our nation, our community of faith, that the grace of the Holy Spirit may continue to sanctify the church and bring healing. Where healing is needed, we pray to the Lord. Let us pray in thanksgiving for the scientists, the health caregivers, as we roll out the vaccine. Let us pray that all peoples, all human beings throughout the planet Earth in which this virus has been affected may have an opportunity to receive the virus, that we may be healed from this virus through these vaccines. For this, let us pray to the Lord. That the mercies of God may inspire us forgiveness and reconciliation among nations, let us pray to the Lord. That Christ our healer may look graciously upon all who have suffered. For this, let us pray to the Lord. Amen. That the Lord may continue to grow in joy and faith those who are preparing to be baptized into Christ's Holy Church at Easter Vigil, and those who will complete their initiation through the other sacraments. For this, let us pray to the Lord. Amen. And for the petitions we hold within our hearts. We pray to the Lord. God of our ancestors, in your kindness, hear our many prayers and answer them according to your will, as we ask them through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer. Which earth has given, human hands have made, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we get this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. acceptable to God the Father Almighty. We bring in these sacrificial gifts, O Lord, to commemorate Blessed Francis of Rome, humble and entreating that they may bestow on us both pardon and salvation through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the marvelous confessions of your saints, you make the church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us sure signs of your love. So, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we do give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. You therefore, Almighty Father, we bless you through Jesus Christ, your Son, who comes in your name. He himself is the word that brings salvation, the hand you extend to sinners, the way by which your peace is offered to us. When we ourselves had turned away from you on account of our sins, you brought us back to be reconciled with God. And so that converted at last to you, we might love one another through your Son, who for our sake you handed over to death. And now, celebrating the reconciliation Christ has brought us, we entreat you, sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, whose command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries. But when about to give his life to set us free, as he reclined at supper, he himself took bread into his hands, and giving you thanks, said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, on that same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing your mercy, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, save you, our Lord. Celebrating, therefore, the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love, we offer you what you have bestowed upon us, the sacrifice of perfect reconciliation. Holy Father, we humbly beseech you to accept us together with your Son, and in this saving banquet, graciously to endow us with his very Spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May you make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all people. And may you keep us in communion with Francis our Pope, Blaise our Bishop, with all the bishops and your entire people. Just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together, the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, your blessed apostles, St. Francis of Rome, and all the saints, and with our brothers and sisters, and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship. Especially praying our attention today for Eleanor Christensen. Bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity and into a new heaven and a new where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him. Takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never let me be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. May the workings of this divine sacrament light and inflame us, Almighty God, on this feast day of Blessed Francis of Rome, that we may be ever fervent with holy desires and abound in good works. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So it's okay if a little air is let out of our tires, right? It's Lent time. We can lose a little weight anyways. God for the day. Peace the Lord be with you.
And
may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and proclaim the good news.
Thanks be to God.